Christ the Lord, calm the storm, weak will be made strong, in the Savior's love, through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Shalom, beloved, shalom, shalom. 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 Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to our 1 hour prayer. Bienvenue à notre une heure de prière. The appointment with the saints. Le rendez-vous des saints. Hallelujah. C'est un rendez-vous. C'est un rendez-vous. Welcome. Welcome. Father, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we acknowledge your presence. We acknowledge your presence. He's a faithful partner. He's a faithful partner. If we are unfaithful, he remains faithful. Father, we thank you. Christ alone. Shalom, shalom. For those that have been waiting, those that have been that have prepared themselves, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. His name is Jehovah. His name is Jehovah. The beginning and the end, the first and the last, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, hallelujah, the Ancient of Days, the Ancient of Days. He said before me, there is no other God, there is no other God, hallelujah, besides me, there is no other God, there is no other God. That's why he said Christ alone, the cornerstone. We're going to make the weak, we're going to transform your life. If you are weak, we're going to make you strong. Through the storm, whatever storm, whatever storm, whatever circumstance, whatever difficulty, turn to God. Hallelujah. Let your difficulty push you back to God, not away from God. Let your difficulty push you to God, and not away from God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Is our Savior, is our Redeemer. Through the storm, you remain Lord, you remain Lord. You cannot change any iota in that circumstance by worry. By worry, you cannot change the circumstances. So what you have to do, let that circumstance push you to God. And the presence of God will be manifest. Listen to the Holy Spirit. Bonjour, bien-aimé. Toi qui nous regardes au travers du monde, de l'Afrique, où que tu te trouves, hallelujah. Que le Seigneur soit ta justice, qu'il soit ta justice, qu'il soit notre justice. Parce qu'il est le seul, il est l'unique. La Bible dit, il a le nom au-dessus de tout nom. Et à la mention du nom de Jésus, tout genou fléchit, toute langue confesse. Même tes problèmes confessent qu'il est Seigneur, il est Dieu. Alléluia. Parce que tes inquiétudes ne peuvent changer rien à ce problème. Donc il faut que si tu traverses des problèmes, des difficultés, il faut que cela te pousse vers Dieu. Que cela te pousse vers Dieu. Cette difficulté, tu dis, parce que c'est trop grand, oui, ça te pousse, il faut que ça te pousse vers Dieu, pas hors de Dieu, pas contre Dieu. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of Lords. Lord, we thank you. We bless your name. Hallelujah. We are up to intercede. I'm Reverend Daniel, coming to you from the United Kingdom. Hallelujah. West Midland. If you are around West Midland, hallelujah, you can visit us, go to our website, Council of Agape Mission Center. We are a center. We train disciples. Hallelujah. We train disciples. We have a Bible study. Hallelujah. That we go thoroughly through the Word of God. We search the Word of God. Hallelujah. Because the Word of God comes to equip the saints, to equip the saints for a good works, If you want to do a good works, you want to be a good steward, you have to study the Word of God. Yes, you have gone to school, you have been in academy, you got a degree, yes, that is good. But the Word of God is what we establish you, beloved. It's what we establish you. Father, we thank you. Hosanna. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to God. Sorry. Jesus, you are Lord. You are the King of Kings. We say, turn to God and be saved. Turn to God. The purpose of turning to God, you and I must have a purpose. A purpose. Why are we turning to God? That's why I say, if we are going through problem, difficulty, those difficulties must not take us away from God, but must push us towards God. Let us feel His presence. Because when you feel the presence of God, whatever pain, whatever wound, whatever hurt, whatever pain you are going through, the presence of God will quench that pain. The presence of God will take away that trouble, that trauma. Because the presence of God come with joy and peace. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Thank you for you that are connected. Share the link. Hallelujah. Because we have to agree with our brother and sister. We have to agree wherever you are, put your comment. And if you have a prayer topic, if you have been oppressed, suppressed during the night, tell me. If you have gone through nightmare, a day you have a bad dream, tell me. This is the time. Hallelujah. David said, I'm waking up in the morning and I lay my request before the Lord and wait in expectation. Hallelujah. Kaboko reka santa. Amen. Glory be to God. Thank you for you that have been faithful. We have been going to work. And there is a time to submit our timesheet. Hallelujah. So today is Friday. Today is the last day of our prayer for this week. So if you have been faithful from Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and today, at the end of this prayer, submit your timesheet to the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Your reward comes from heaven, beloved. Your reward is not coming from me. Your reward is not coming from the earthly institution. But your reward is coming from where there is no tarry. There is no, hallelujah, lack. That's why the Bible says He's the source of our happiness. Let God be the source of your happiness. Because if it's not God, which is the source of your happiness, oh Kaboko, when the things that is making you happy will be gone, you will come back to your first state. So I come to pray with someone this morning. Let God be our source of joy. Let God be our source of living. He said, turn to God and be saved. Isaiah 45:22. Turn to God and be saved. When you go to 23 and 24, he said, why? Because before him every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess his name. Every tongue will confess his name. Hallelujah. Every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow. Whatever situation that tried to overtake you, have dominion on you, the name of Jesus will subdue that problem, that situation. Just mention his name. Just call upon his name. Just come closer to God, and he will give you takasakabe in the mighty name of Jesus. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. You are serving a living God, beloved. I say, when we turn to God, when we come to God, hallelujah, we must have a purpose. We must have a purpose. What is your purpose? What is your purpose of giving your life to Christ? What is the purpose to being crucified with Christ? Hallelujah. If you have been crucified with Christ, you will not be crying as an unbeliever, the Bible said. You will not be murmuring or crying or weeping as an unbeliever, because the Bible says you know the truth, you know what the future holds, you know the promise of God towards you. He said, turn to me and be saved, turn to me and be healed, turn to me to be lifted, turn to me, I will lift you up. Yes, Christina. Where is the interpretation? Hallelujah. Turn to me, and you will be lifted up. If you want to be lifted up, pray that prayer. Say, Lord, lift me up this morning. Oh God, I have been down for so long. I have been in this situation for a long time. It's a time of turnaround. Father, it's my time of turnaround. I said, someone, hallelujah, I can see your situation turn into your favor. I can see that situation, that pandemic. I can see, oh, Kaboko, say, you have a court case. God will vindicate you, because to me the vengeance, in the mighty name of Jesus. You have to be happy, beloved. Turn to God with a purpose. Hallelujah. He will prosper you. Oh, you want to do this, you want to do that, you want to buy this, you want to buy that, but you doesn't have money. It's like you are working, but you seem not to be working. But I say, turn to God, he will prosper you. He said, Silvers and gold belongs to me. We go to work 24 hours, but still we are not rich. Still we still lack. But God said, silvers and gold belongs to me. But what the Lord requires from you and I is your faithfulness, is my faithfulness. So Lord, I want to be faithful to you. Lord, let your faithfulness, oh Lord Jesus, envelop me. Let your faithfulness, let your righteousness, let your strength, let your joy, your peace envelop me. Pray that prayer in the name of Jesus. I say we should turn to God with a purpose. What is the purpose? Quel est ton but? Quel est le but pour lequel tu sers Dieu? Quel est le but? Et tu dois avoir un but. Hallelujah. Et cette situation doit t'amener à chercher la face de Dieu, à te rapprocher de Dieu. Au nom de Jésus, Hakabori Naraseke, O Letabaseke, Yataraba, Hosanna, Hosanna. He said, when you are tired and weak, that is the time to say, Lord, you are my strength. You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my only hope. It's your only hope. Let him be your only hope in the mighty name of Jesus. Il est ta force quand tu es faible. Il est ta force quand tu es faible. Tu dois venir vers lui parce que tu es faible. Tu dois venir vers lui parce que tu veux la solution à ce problème, à cette situation. Il est la solution. Qu'il soit ton centre de distribution. Qu'il soit ton centre de distribution. Au nom puissant de Jésus. Yes, Christina, where is the Romanian word? I want to pray with my Romanian friends. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Turn to God when you are tired and weak. When you are tired of a situation, give it
it to God. Drop it down. That's why he said, come to me. Come to me, you that are weary. You that are tired. You that are worried and heavy laden. Your shoulder is heavy. Your head is heavy. It's like you are carrying a bag of cement. You are carrying a weight. To Kabaseke, just drop it down. That extra luggage, that extra luggage. When you go to the airport with extra luggage, they will charge you a lot of money. So don't allow the enemy to charge and do charge you. Hakawoi, drop it down. It say you that are heavy laden, that heavy burden, lay it down. Lay it down at the feet of Jesus. At the feet of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come to God. Talk to God to receive your gift. Hallelujah. He have a gift for you. He have a gift for you. He have a gift for you and I. Turn to God. Pray that prayer. Pray that prayer. Lord, I need my gift. I need my gift. I need to exercise my gift. I need to you that want to exercise your gift. Multuneste domnezeu. Hallelujah. Kabo karabakanesti obsbosi. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I love that. I love that. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. He said, you have a gift for you. He have a gift for you. December is coming. We prepare a gift for people. God is giving you gift 365 days of years in the year in the name of Jesus. Every day, he have a gift for you. Come with humility, come with humbleness, and then you will receive your gift. You will receive your gift. You will receive it. Will rekindle that gift. Rekindle that gift. He gave you gift yesterday. He gave you gift after before yesterday. But you that gift is dormant. That gift is not being used. Come to God and he rekindle it in the mind. In the name of Jesus. Listen. James chapter 1 verse 17. Let me read for our French community. Let you see what James said. James chapter 1 verse 17. He said, tout don excellent et tout cadeau parfait descend du ciel. Ils viennent de Dieu, le créateur des lumières célestes, et Dieu ne change pas. Il ne produit pas d'ombre par des variations de position. Hallelujah. James is saying to us that, hallelujah. James chapter 1 verse 17, Christina, hallelujah. Thank you. Put it in Spanish. Thank you. Welcome, daughter. Shalom. Hallelujah. Say shalom, Papa. God bless you. Radeke bakasoko reka sataraba. You guys are soldiers of Christ. A soldier wherever you see the parachute, they can parachute a soldier everywhere and he will start bullet. They can parachute him. You can parachute him everywhere. So it doesn't matter. Somebody say, oh, because I travel, pastor, that's why you can't see me. I do this, I do that. No. The parachute, a soldier, they parachute them everywhere. And then they will be, they don't drop their gun. They come down with every bullet, every protection on them. That's why when you are in Spain, when you are in Turkey, when you are in Africa, Australia, America, Asia, hallelujah, India, there are people in India that are appreciating us. Another one sent me a message yesterday. He said, Pastor, thank you. Switzerland. He said, thank you for your daily prayer. They can parachute you everywhere. So you be a soldier, you take territory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. James chapter 1 verse 17, I haven't forget. He said, every perfect gift comes from God. Come from above. Every perfect gift. I can give you a gift. You will use it and you will finish. But the gift that God has given you, nobody can take it from you. Parota satara. You have a gift of singing. Nobody can take it from you. You have a gift of preaching. Nobody can take it from you. You have a gift of evangelizing. Nobody can take it from you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Turn to Jesus. For his life. Turn to him and eat, he is life. He will give you life. He will give you life. He will surely give you life. You see, doctors are in the hospital. They are trying their best to bring life. That's why they are putting machine, because they themselves, they cannot give you life. They cannot breathe into your nostril. That's why they are putting you on the machine. They are putting you on the oxygen. But God doesn't need oxygen. God doesn't need machine. God just breathe. Just breathe in you. Breathe on me. Breathe on me. Holy Ghost fire. Breathe on me. I hope you are praying that prayer. Breathe on me. Take God. Breathe on me this morning. Breathe on me this morning, Lord. Breathe on me. Breathe on my children. They are going to school. Breathe on my children. They are going to school. Breathe on. Because when God breathes in you, hallelujah, you receive life. You receive life. Turn to Jesus. He will give you life. He's a life giver. He's a life giver. If everything is dead, if there's a deadly situation, Lazarus was dead. Lazarus was dead. But when Jesus appeared, he came back into the tomb. He came back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is a life giver. Is a life giver. It will receive, Father. You will receive life. You will receive life. Pray that prayer. Say, I'm receiving. I'm receiving life. Yes, sir. Doctor is the hospital. Yes, doctor in the hospital. Te connecteza. Where is the Spanish one? Paroco sacaraba. Kazapoti tre. Thank you, Jesus. Give me the tongue that I should pronounce it very well. Father, give me the tongue that I should pronounce these languages very well. Es respira viesta peste. Peste, amen. Satan to Jesus, he will give you life. Life more, life abundant. Life abundant. He said he will lead you beside the stream water. He will lead you beside the stream water. Father, lead me. Lead me. Lead me. Be my leader. Be my leader. Be my leader. Pray that prayer. Be my leader. Be my leader. Lead me. I don't want anybody to lead me. I don't want anybody to show me what to do today. You, God, tell me what to do. Tell me where to go in the mighty name of Jesus. Your friend will take you to church and your friend will take you out of the church. That is not you. That means you are not born again. That means you don't know who you are following. Say, Lord, lead me beside the stream water. I say, I come to pray for someone this morning. The Lord have to reveal this thing to us so that we may stand at the gap, so you don't fall into the trap of the enemy in the name of Jesus. Yes, he took you to the church. He showed you the way. But when you see the way and then somebody is taking you out of the way, you must stand on your ground and say, I'm mature enough to make my decision.
Oh my God.
He said, I will lead you into the stream water, not into the river, the desert. And not just into the stream water, but the green pasture. What about the green pasture? The green pasture. So you will have food. You will have green food. Green food. You see, every food we are eating today are chemical. They are no more green. Paroko seke. They are trying their best to make it green, but still, it's killing us. Because what we are eating is what is killing us. Mm-hmm. So we have to go back to God and say, Lord, take me back to the green pasture. Mm-hmm. Take me back to the green pasture in the mighty name of Jesus. I hope somebody is praying this prayer. Yes, yes, I saw the Spanish one. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Maria. God bless you. God will use you to interpret. God will use you. Just start exercising it. Just start exercising it. Just start exercising it. Christina, you are doing well in the mighty name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit will improve it. We compliment it. Dakade, dakatel, dakatelasi, dakatelasi, kondusi, de opa, hase, kerebe, kotaka. Hey, Lord, help me. Kondo de hi, da nu de dolmu. Papa Soko, yes, hallelujah. Ira baba, lasa te kont, lata se Secondot do the mole. Yes, you that has, you can hear the tongue of heaven. You can hear the God hear every languages. What a mighty God we serve. I say, turn to God. Turn to God. He will lead you in beside the steam water. He will lead you beside the green pasture. He will take us to the land where flowing milk and honey. That's what he told Abraham. I will take you. Hallelujah. Bakasoko. Yes, yes, yes. I was with my daughter some days ago. We were remembering. She will remember the poorest place. The poorest place where she come from. They say, Papa, you see, from childhood, I grow in this environment. I grow in that type of environment. Very poor and very cold. The Lord has brought you where there is a honey and milk, and you cannot thank him, and you cannot recognize that by Roko Seke, there is something wrong with you. Parore Kasatabare, you are where you are, not because you are strong, not because you have money, but because God relocates you. God relocates you. He will relocate you in the mighty name of Jesus. May God relocate you. If you are not happy where you are, turn to God, and he will relocate you. He will take you where there is a honey, there is a milk, in the mighty name of Jesus. He said, turn to me, hallelujah. He didn't say turn to a man, he didn't say turn to an organization, he said turn to me. He is your battle ass, is your fighter, is your Avenger. He is your avenger. Open your Bible, Deuteronomy 32, 35. Yes, je disais que revenons à Dieu. Revenons à Dieu. Il va nous conduire vers les verts pâturages. Il va nous conduire vers des eaux paisibles. Quand tu reviens à Dieu, il ne t'amène pas au désert. Et même quand il a amené ses enfants au désert, il s'est en chargé de les nourrir. If that wilderness you are going through, and then you are with God, he will send manna. He will send you manna. But if you go that to that desert because wilderness, because you are running from God, because the problem is too much, you will have warm. You will be having the warm there in the mighty name of Jesus. It's not your portion, it's not my portion. Because my God, he will take me beside the stream water. I say, if you have been attacked, it's your avenger. Deuteronomy 32, 35. He said, I will repay them back. Only God have the ability to pay. Hallelujah. That's why even in the book of Romans chapter 12, he said, dear friend, never avenge yourself. Never avenge yourself. Whatever man will do to you, write the word of Romans chapter 12 verse 19 and put in your front doors. He said, dear friend, never avenge yourself. Leave that to God. Amen. It's written like that, though. I'm not inventing. He said, leave that to God. For it is written, I will take vengeance. I will repay those who deserve it. Yes, tant que je te lis ça en français, hallelujah. Romains chapitre 12, verset 19. Romains 12, 19. C'est quand tu es attaqué, ne te venge pas. Il dit que laisse-moi la vengeance, à moi la rétribution, à moi la vengeance. Pourquoi veux-tu te venger? Pourquoi veux-tu répondre à ce frère, à cette sœur? Ce n'est pas le temps que tu dois répondre au nom puissant de Jésus. Romains chapitre 12, verset 19. Il dit, mes chers amis, ne vous vengez pas vous-même, mais laissez agir la colère de Dieu, car l'Écriture déclare, c'est moi qui tirerai vengeance, c'est moi qui payerai de retour, dit le Seigneur. Yes. Put it in Romanian. Put it in Spanish. Yes, that's thank you. Go rabaseke. He said, don't avenge. Don't revenge. Never. He said, never, never avenge yourself. Leave that to God. For it is written, I will take vengeance.
Yeah.
I will repay those who deserve it. Those who deserve it. That means if you doesn't do anything, then God, you are in, by the side of God. But if you attack his children, I'm feel sorry. Verse 17, if you see verse 17, that at 19 as I read, verse 17's name, never pay back evil for evil. Yes, go a little bit up and read 17. Never pay back evil for evil. Maybe what you are doing, you don't know that is evil. But we that have the spirit of God, we see that is evil, we don't respond. Yes, we just turn to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't check your action. Check your action. Check your action. Lord, help me. Help me to check my action. Help me to check my action towards my brother, towards my sister, towards my nation, towards my church, towards my ministry. In the mighty name of Jesus. He said, don't repay evil for evil. Because the person that is doing it, he doesn't know that it's evil. But you that are spirit-filled, the Holy Spirit will say, keep calm. Keep calm, my daughter. Keep calm, my son. Keep calm. Keep calm. Oh, let the peace of God fill your heart. Let if you have been feel rejected, if you have been feel miserable, maltreated, abandoned, oh, the word of God for you this morning, keep calm. Keep calm, keep calm. I know I am God. Keep quiet and know I am God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let me tell you to the next verse before Mama come, before Apostle come. Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10 verse 30. Hebrews 10:30. It says, for we know the one who said, I will repay those who deserve it. Do you know? Maybe you think that, hallelujah, hallelujah. Maybe you think that you don't know. No. Do you know who said, I will repay those? I will repay them. That means the battle is not yours. The battle is not ours. The battle is not ours. Lord, give me peace in the midst of storm. Give me peace in the midst of rejection. In the mighty name of Jesus. He said, don't repay evil for evil. Romans chapter 12. Please, 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 please. We try to, you see, our mortal body, our spirit, our carnal man want to revenge. Please, to revenge, please, to revenge. Our mortal man want to react. Yeah, Kaboseke. Short temper. If you are short temper, I'm going to pray for you this morning. Say, read Romans chapter 12. From Deuteronomy 32, Pakori Kasanda, he said, no, God said, from the Old Testament to the New Testament, beloved, he said, I will take vengeance. I will take vengeance and I will repay those who deserve it. Mandeku. So lay down in peace. In peace. In the mighty name of Jesus. So turn away from the lies and the false belief. Turn away. You run. When somebody lies to you, he lied on your name. He accused you falsely. Run. Run. He said, turn to God. Hallelujah. Turn away from the lies of false belief. We must turn to the truth. Turn to the truth. Turn to the truth. The more we look to the create to our Creator, the more we look like Him. The more you look to your Creator, the more you look like Him. Hallelujah. Because the devil tried to blaspheme you, the devil tried to give you another name, the devil tried to call you all sorts of names. But when you turn to God, you will have the image of God. You will have the image of God. He will clothe you with His glory. His glory will clothe you. I pray this morning, may the glory of God clothe you. Clothe you in the mighty name of Jesus. Clothe us, Lord. Clothe us. He said, let Let us be clothed with Jesus Christ. He's the author and the finisher of our faith. Christ in you, the hope of glory. Apostle is coming. Turn to the cross. That's my final word for you this morning. Turn to the cross. 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 And run away from the lies of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. Sunday 10th. If you are not in the United Kingdom, you are not in West Midland, tune to our Facebook page. 10 o'clock, we will be live to bring the word of God to you. Remain blessed. Let the light of God shine upon you and lay down every situation to God in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen, 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 hallelujah. Amen. Amen, 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 hallelujah. My daughter Christina said, amen, amen, hallelujah. Gina was watching and she was online yesterday, hallelujah. I just asked her to connect again this morning because we are soldiers of Christ, hallelujah. We are the soldiers of Christ, we are the soldiers of Christ. In the name of Jesus, we are the soldiers of Christ, hallelujah. And we're gonna stand still to serve our God. Nothing is shaking us. Every day we will turn to Him. Every day we're gonna turn to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, my daughter Kaka. My God, she's connected today and we have been praying for you. But I was worried that Kaka is so quiet. I don't know, because of the two children now. She becomes the mother of two, so it's not easy. Hallelujah. Experiencing two children is not easy. Hallelujah. We are praying for you. The grace of God is sufficient. Amen. Christina, we pass you the anointing. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Because she got two heavy boys. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Geraldine, Deaconess will pass you the anointing. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you very much. This is Fountain of Agape Mission Center. As the man of God, I've just introduced the ministry. And we are in the air from Tuesday to Friday. Listen. Tuesday to Friday. Tuesday to Friday, we are in the air. To do what? In this platform. Hallelujah. To do what? To motivate. To stir up our spirit. To refresh our mind. Hallelujah. To renew our relationship with God. To rekindle the fire that the Lord has put in us in His word. Hallelujah. To rekindle it. To stir it up. Our gift. Hallelujah. To tell the devil that I cannot sleep. Oh, yes. Tell me if you are enrolled in the army, natural army of the world, and you are enrolled in the army and they sent you, hallelujah, somewhere in a country that there is war. Oh my God, they wake up very early and they strategize themselves to face the enemy. Beloved, know that we are in the battle. If you are that Christian that is sleeping, oh my God, the only way to come to turn to God is to get strength, is to get strength. That's why we are turning to Him every day. If you don't know in your mind that you are in the battlefield, you are not yet come, you are not yet reached that place, you are not yet. That's why we are up every morning. Why? To refresh. I'm not up because of you, you are not up because of me. Hallelujah. I'm up because I want God to speak in my spirit. I'm up because I want to be reconnected with God every morning. I want to hear from God. I'm up because God has positioned me. Ramaseke makarobo sokuria makaseke remasanda redede. God has put you in that area, in that neighborhood. You are the light. Hallelujah. To do what? You are the watchman watching. My God, if you are a security person in the company or in the shop, and then they put you there at the door and then you begin to sleep, my God, people will carry everything and go. And that is how many Christians are. God called us watchmen, but we are sleeping, beloved. We don't watch over what the Lord has Hallelujah, have assigned to us. So this morning we are turning to God. My God, we are turning to God this morning, you and I. We are turning to Him to do what? To refresh us, to give us the grace and the strength. To give us the strength to stand up. Listen, this didn't start yet. Even since we were back home, our children, every day they were still. We wake up 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, and we pray before they go to school. We pray before they go to school. Because we know that it's a battlefield. My God, because we don't know where we are going to go. Everyone that was in our heart, everybody, we are waking up 5 a.m. It has been our custom. Everybody must wake up 5 a.m. And let me tell you, all those children, all of them, men and women, they are not pastors. All of them. Some are married to pastor and they themselves, they are pastor, men of God, apostle, bishop, all of them. You see the training ground? The training ground will make you, if you are trained, if you are disciplined in your life and you are the military person that is disciplined, that is obedient and humble, hallelujah, to where God has placed you, how do they call it, to your battalion, God has placed you, you will be a colonel, you will be a commander, you will be... No, remain simple soldiers. God, your leader will, they will be giving your country, will be giving you God, because increase. You are winning the battle. My God, tell me how God will not give me God, massacre here. Tell me how God will not give you God as you are winning the battle, as you are you position yourself. You tell me how God will not give you God, my kareba seke rema seke. Beloved, this morning I've come to tell you this morning. This is a secret. To be a soldier of God, first of all, you need to be disciplined. Turn to God every day. How you make up your mind to turn to God every day is a discipline. I want you to pray this prayer. Lord, help me to discipline my Christian life. Pray that prayer. Pray it this morning. Lord, help me to discipline my Christian life. Help me to discipline my Christian life. I can tell where you are going in the church. I can tell. We can tell. We know those that are really that God will use. We know because discipline, my God, we can tell. My say, your leader can tell where you are going. He can say, no, my God, I have to pray for you this morning that the Lord will empower you with the spirit, the scale of discipline in the name of Jesus. This does not come by diploma or by PhD. It doesn't come. Let me tell you, when you go to university, you have many have got PhD, but is under their pillow. They don't have the job. They don't have the job or the career that they went to school for. They don't have it. But with God, when you go, when you pass through the school of God, my God, God will lift you up. You will become, hallelujah, the glory of God will shine upon you. You will become distinguished, my God. God will never allow the enemy, as you turn to God every day, He will never allow your enemies to overshadow you. Never. I'm a living testimony. We are a living testimony. It will never allow your enemy to overshadow you. Never. Makaso Korea Bakaseki. Ye Masaka. Pray that Lord give me a life of discipline. Give me that life of discipline. As you are enrolling in your army, God, the Jesus have enrolled us. The Bible says He's the commander in chief. Jesus is the one, you know, when you are the commander, you watch over the people that you have recruited. You watch over them that are disciplined. You watch over the ones that are respectful, that are really, really doing what you're asking them to do. You promote them. Father, Lord, I pray for somebody this morning. Hallelujah, that has been disciplined. I pray for someone promotion. This morning. Hallelujah, pray for promotion. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah, you'll be promoted. Mm-hmm. In your career, you're going to be promoted. In your ministry, you'll be promoted. Don't give up. In the name of Jesus. The time of God is coming. You don't know the time. I don't know the time. So that's why we have to position ourselves. Let no person push you away. The entity, the people that the enemy is using around you, my God, be strategized, stand strong, makarene moko seke, halayeba sikareina baka seke, stand firm upon the rock in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Yes, God will position you as you turn to Him. It will position you like, listen, God will never disappoint you. I pray that you will not see shame. You will never experience shame in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, doors that are open for you, you will enter there freely and you will carry spoil everything. You take all the important things. And listen, God is there to watch over us. If we are obedient to him, if you are, yes, if you say, Lord, here I am, hallelujah, humble yourself. Say, Lord, here I am. Whatever thing I'm going to listen, they follow David. When I read the Bible, I just start laughing. Because the enemy of David, they follow him. Instead of him to revenge, this is a mighty soldier. He was running, running away for his life. Even his own son persecuted him. I believe it was his own son persecuted. He was running from his son, running. My God. That's why God, the Bible says, the man of God already said in the book of Romans, he said, do not revenge. Run away for them that are persecuted. Don't stand there to say, I'm strong. Run. David ran from his life. He ran away from his own son. What happened? His son. What happened? God revenged his cause. I'm seeing you. I'm seeing you being catapulted in your position. God is fighting your battle. God is fighting your battle, beloved. Stand still and do what the Lord has asked you to do. Do not be distracted. My God, all those things around is just full distraction from the enemy. Pray for you this morning. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, do not allow your flesh to dominate the spirit. My God, I've come to release the power of God in your life, that your eyes will be open in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that you'll be celebrated in every position. You're going to be celebrated. Do not look at the past. Look at the future, beloved. The future is brighter. The future is brighter, my God. That's why the Bible says, do not pay evil with evil. Hallelujah. Let your good overshadow the evil thing. You that are discouraged have come to release the word of God in your life this morning. Turn to God and you will be strengthened. Turn to God and the peace of God will fill your heart. Just be obedient. Just be humble and respectful. Hallelujah. Do not avenge yourself. Do not avenge yourself. Do not try to justify. God is the one that sees the heart. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Yes. Turn to God. That is the only solution. Turn to him. Turn to God with all your heart, with all your mind. Hallelujah. I've never seen in the Bible those that have turned to God, the Lord have abandoned them. The hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God is here. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Turn to him with all your heart. Hallelujah. Allow him to do his work. He said, no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. No weapon of the enemy shall prosper. My God, I can see you've been doing good to so many people, but now they've turned against you. My But God, hallelujah, will never leave you to shame. He will never allow shame, mama. Saka. Hallelujah. The Lord has the best. Yes, he got the best position for you. He got the best answer. Hallelujah. We come here and say that we just laugh at the enemy. We just laugh at him. You come and state that you don't get angry anymore. You just began to laugh. Why? Because you know the result. You know the outcome. The outcome is positive, beloved. It's not negative. It is positive. My God, I can pray for you this morning and say, Lord, hallelujah, lift up the spirit of my sister, lift up the spirit of my brother. Maybe in the workplace, hallelujah, from the manager, the director, you are doing, trying to do your best, but you have not been seen. But don't worry, stay there and begin just to pray. Hallelujah, don't avenge yourself in the name of Jesus Christ. Maybe they don't recognize what you are trying to contribute or to give. My God, hallelujah, but the Bible Bible says. He sees everything. He sees you are going out and you are coming in. You do not see. That's why many people go out and they don't come back. Hallelujah. If you know you're going to go out and you're going to meet, hallelujah, an enemy that will shoot you down or an accident, beloved, you will never go out. Hallelujah. That's why we don't know the future. The future belongs to God, beloved. So just turn to God. Let Lord, I lift up my hands. Lift up your hands. Hallelujah. As I speak, I'm speaking in your spirit, in your subconscious. That will take it to your spirit. Let me tell you, your subconscious is the mic. Is that mic? Hallelujah. When you're in the church, you use the mic. And then when you speak in the mic, it take it to the subconscious. And then the subconscious will take it to our spirit. It will elaborate it, coordinate it, and give us the right answer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I'm speaking to you. I'm speaking to myself. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory. I encourage you that when every time you wake up, just turn to God. Just turn to God. Hallelujah. That's why King David did not take his request of prayer to a man. He took it to the altar of God. He said, early in the morning, hallelujah, glory be to God. I don't know whether you know that verse in the book of Psalm chapter 5. He said, early in the morning, listen, early in the morning, I wake up and I lay my request. Hallelujah. Oh, King David, glory be to God. Listen, I lay my request to God. And I wait in expectation. Many people rush. When they lay their request, they rush most of the, they rush, they want to get the answer. They manipulate, they try the answer themselves. I carry the rebel so come sikara. You don't know. He lays his request to the Lord and he waits in expectation. He will hear what the Lord will tell you. And Habakkuk said the same thing. I am in my post. Hallelujah. I am standing in my post. I'm waiting to hear what God is going to tell me. Ha ye karina masoko rabaseke. What the Lord has told you 10 years ago past, what the Lord has told you, if he has never come to pass, hallelujah, still waiting. Hallelujah. Pray for the spirit of waiting. Waiting. God has said you're going to be conceived a baby and so on. Wait for the Lord. Turn to God. Hallelujah. He's the one that created the womb of Anna. My God, God is so powerful. Anything that is not functioning, when you turn to him, he will recreate. He will create everything. Because he got the spare part in heaven. Original, let me tell you, the original spare part of your body, from head to toe, all your hair is, hallelujah, is in heaven. God is able, let's say, God is able to recreate, to rejuvenate, hallelujah, to bring everything new in your system. In the name of Jesus Christ, every broken bones, the Lord will heal. The great physician, this morning I've come to speak to someone like that is very, very sick, very, very affected, hallelujah, with demonic and nightmare. You don't know where the sickness is coming from. Everything they've done, hallelujah, this is the solution. Turn to God. He is going to heal you from head to toe. He will heal you. And when he heals you, he's not healing you. Oh my God, God is so powerful. He doesn't heal you and give you drug or began to bring down, hallelujah, the prescription. Oh, now you are getting healed. Stop, take 2 a day. Oh, you were taking every day 5. No, take 2 a day. Take for 2 days in a week or 1 day in a month. No, God heals you totally. Say, behold, I'm the God that healed thee. Hallelujah, I healed thee. Oh my God, I've come to pray for you this morning. Pray for those that are in the hospital as well. Pray for the children that are sick. We are releasing the power of healing as we are turning to God to get the solution. Is to release the power of healing upon the life of the ones of our beloved ones, upon the life of our family. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Turn to God, beloved. There is no any other solution anywhere. You may think that your money is your solution. You may think that your career is your solution. You may think that the business you are doing is the solution because you want to please your emotion. You want to please your life. You want to please yourself. Hallelujah. That little echo, that pride. I want to have money to show them that. No, you may think that that is the solution, beloved, but those things, Jesus said, they will pass passed away. Heaven and earth will pass away. Who knows that COVID-19 is going to happen in this time? No person knows. But God, the creator, knows. It's the more people are going astray, the more we are seeing negative results. People are positive. God is bringing people back onto when we will understand that we are turning back to Jesus. Everyone should turn to Jesus. It's the last solution. My God, listen. When the Lord took the children of Israel from Egypt to the desert, my God, hallelujah, there were no hospital, no place, no shopping center, no Sainsbury, no Primark, nothing. Listen, the Bible said the Lord was feeding them Akaseke 40 years. The Lord was feeding them. He was feeding them. He was clothing them. As they were growing, their clothes was growing. Oh, what a miracle God we are serving, beloved. Hallelujah, we are in the best position. I am in the best position. So this morning I'm praying for you. Do not give up, beloved. Do not give up. You're going to be celebrated. Hallelujah. Your enemy will begin to see the God we are serving. The Lord told, he said to Naaman, he said, the time will come. I will make a difference. Truly, I will show, hallelujah, those that really serve God and those that were playing. If you're in the church playing with your Christian life, you are in the church because someone there. You are in the church because, hallelujah, your brother, your sister, your mother, or somebody is there. Hallelujah. You are playing. The Bible says, Jesus, the Bible says, God said, I'm going to make a difference for the one that really serve God and the one that are playing. And Jesus said it too. He said, I'm coming to rapture the church that doesn't have any wrinkle or stain. My God, I don't want to be saved by fire. I don't want to be saved when Antichrist will come, when God will remove his church. That's when Antichrist will come to start to tell you, people, if you reject or believe God, I'm going to leave you. Put the mark. That is why. But those that the conquerors, the overcomers, will be taken away. Beloved, I pray for you this morning that the power of God will give you strength and stability where you are. You will not be shaken, my God. You will never be shaken, because the Lord Almighty said, the Lord said, I discipline my children, not because he hates us, but because he loves us, because he wants to take us to a perfect way. Hallelujah. That's why to be a commander in chief in a battalion, hallelujah, you need a disciplined life. They don't just put ambassador in a country like that. They don't put rebellion ambassador in any nation. No, they will put someone that has been disciplined, someone that have been faithful serving the government, hallelujah, someone that have been faithful having the desire to do the things of this country. That's the person they're going to put, beloved. If the world can be obedient to a man, we are disobedient to God, beloved. We have to turn back to God. This is the time to reassess our Christian life. God, I pray for my brothers, hallelujah, and my sister, that as we turn to you, Lord, we will not see shame. We will not suffer shame in the name of Jesus. Our Christian life, hallelujah. My God. God will give us solution. He will give us solution in every battle that has been set against you, against me. The Lord will give you solution. The Lord will look the way out from you. In the name of Jesus Christ, every battle, every little battle that have been set, my God, to destroy your career, to weaken you, to destabilize you, to bring confusion, hallelujah, in your house, in your family, every battle that have been set, beloved, he will give you solution. He will give me solution. Hallelujah. My karede boko sikara maseke ria baka seke. Hallelujah. Kaseke. God will set. He will set an open door. And open a prophesy. Say, do not give up. Do not be discouraged. Hallelujah. You are in the training ground. You are in the training ground. My God. You don't know the training the Lord is taking us. You don't know the training the Lord is taking you. You cannot be that purified. A goal to be purified. A goal to be that really goal that everybody will admire. That goal need to pass through fire. Need to pass through fire. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You need to soar, my Lord. Soar like an eagle. Ye kasak. I said, those that wait upon the Lord, hallelujah, they will rise up. They will soar like an eagle. Ha masakarina baka sokore baseke. This is the last day of our prayer for turn to God this week. Turn to God is a very powerful thing. When the children of Israel, they were going astray, Joshua said, turn to God. Hallelujah. They were beginning to be rebellious. Gideon. Joshua told them, turn to God, serve the Lord Almighty, the one that brought you out from Egypt, the one that gave you manna in the desert, the one that clothed you. Turn to him. They started rebelling again. Makaseke, that rebellion spirit, I come against it in your ministry, in the name of Jesus, in your life. Your children have been rebelling. Hallelujah. Every time I come against it, and I pray that God will give you the heart of patience to be stable in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Your husbands, I don't want to believe. The more you talk to him about God, the more, hallelujah, my God, the more it will be rebellion. Your wife, the same thing. Hallelujah. Vice versa. Either it's the husband or it's the wife. This morning I've come to release on the children or the friends. This morning I've come to release the anointing. Hallelujah. Of beating. That when you turn to God, God will fight your battle, beloved. He will fight your battle. And you know, many things are happening because people don't have patience. They don't have patience to wait when God is there to bring their blessing. Pop, they move away. They move away. They don't have patience to wait. That husband, now you say that husband is the worst husband in the world. Hallelujah. The Bible says another person poison is another person meat. That husband, that wife, you think is the worst woman, is the worst husband. That you go, yes, that when you turn to God and commit him to the Lord, yeah. Say, Lord, this is the man you have given me. This is the wife you have given me. Hallelujah. Or well, maybe by mistake or whatsoever, but Lord, we have gotten married and this is him. Hallelujah. The Bible says a wife, a woman shall be sanctified for the believer. If your wife is believer and you are unbeliever, then you, the husband, you are sanctified. If your husband is unbeliever and your wife is a believer, you, the wife, you are sanctified. You turn to God and say, God, this is the husband you've given me. Hallelujah. Because he created all on the own image. You turn to and say, Lord, I present you my husband, you are present to my wife, I present to my children. Do not revenge, do not try to please your emotion, to shout and to do this and do that. No, don't do that. Hallelujah. Just present the case to God. Hallelujah. That's what David did when they came. Hallelujah. The Amalekite, they came and carried everything when he went to war and to serve his people, and he came back. He took soldiers to war. Listen, when he came back, everything was gone. The spoil, they carried the wife of his soldier, everything. He did not, even his own people that went to win the war, they were against him. Oh yeah, why are you annoyed because people are against you? Why are you annoyed because someone, hallelujah, my God, I've come to pray to you. What David did, he turned to God. He said, Lord, he went to acquire from the Lord. Should I pursue? Can I follow them? The Lord said, yes, go. When we turn to God, God will give us the right direction. Father, I pray for you this morning. In every angle of your life, in every situation that you are going through, in your life, in your family, in your career, in your workplace, hallelujah, I pray that when you turn to God, hallelujah, the Lord will lift your countenance up. He will lift your countenance up. Hallelujah, as the star is shining and being steady, your blessing will be steady. No person will divert it. In the name of Jesus Christ, you began to move forward. You be the head and never the tail. You be above and never beneath. You be victorious in everything you are doing. The favor, the supernatural favor of God will usher you to greatness. Hallelujah. The supernatural favor of God. Hallelujah. They look at you as an ordinary person, but you be an extraordinary in the midst of problem, in the midst of trouble. You're going to be an extraordinary person. Your solution of your friends and people around you and neighbor, their solution is in your hands. You are the light of that nation. You are the light of that neighborhood. You are the light of that community. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you will never be shaken, beloved. Hallelujah. Name them. The Lord will empower you. The Lord will refresh you as you move forward this week. As this weekend, the Lord will empower you. The Lord will refresh you. People will start to call you. You are blessed. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Something strange is going to happen. Something wonderful. miracle will take place. Your package of blessing is coming at your door. That job that you'll be looking for, hallelujah, they're going to look for you, my God. They're going to look for you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lord. Hallelujah. This morning, I'm so excited. Every morning is a new thing. God say, I'm doing a new thing every day. I am doing a new thing. Hallelujah. The new thing that the Lord is doing is to refresh us, to rejuvenate us. The new thing that he's doing is to empower us, is to sharpen us, is to ensure the new thing, hallelujah, that he's doing. He's doing a new thing, opening our spiritual understanding, our spiritual eyes to see the direction. He said, and then when you turn to me, I will show you the way you should go. My God, God is so powerful. Hallelujah, he's so powerful. Father, I pray for my beloved one. I pray for my sister. I pray for my brother. I pray for the viewers that are viewing us, oh my God. I pray that the eyes will be open. I pray that they will see the way that you are showing them. I pray that, my God, in their family, they will be the light. They will be the head and never the knee. They will be on top and never beneath. I pray that they will be victorious and overcomers. In every situation, every battle that is set against them, you will give them the solution. You will give them the solution. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I thank you for those that have connected throughout this week. Even the one that have connected today, my God, Father, you pay us the same. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, glory be to God. I bless the name of the Lord because you are there every day, and it's because of your encouragement, hallelujah, your persistence, it's because of your perseverance that push us to be in this platform, beloved. We encourage one another. The Bible says iron sharpen iron. If you go to be in a group of people that will not sharpen you, your spirit will be dead. If that will not encourage you, your spirit will be dead. But this morning I pray that as you listen to the sound of our voices this morning, your spirit, hallelujah, will kick up. It will boost your spiritual spirit. Hallelujah. As they say, boost your immune system. Your spiritual spirit will be boosted in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Thank you, beloved. Hallelujah. On Sunday, we are in our area. Everything is being taken care of. PPA is there. Hallelujah. We got camouflage to take temperature. Everything is being clean and sanitized. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Sanitize and put everything. So invite someone to come. Hallelujah. So that we can fellowship together. When we are two or three, hallelujah, we fellowship together. In the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. There is liberty. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, invite someone. 10 a.m. to 11:45. We are there, hallelujah, to worship God, to praise the name of the Lord. Wonderful people of God, hallelujah. Glory be to God. And when the word of God comes, it will heal, deliver, restore, hallelujah, and position everyone. Thank you. I will not leave the platform as always do to give the word of God for someone that is being connected for the first time, and doesn't know Jesus Christ as his personal Lord and Savior. As you receive him in your heart and confess with your mouth, say, Lord Jesus, I confess your mother, you are the Lord of Lords. I receive you. I invite you in my heart. Be my Lord and Savior. Wash all my sin away. I was ignorant for my past sin. I've been doing wrong stuff. And now I've heard your voice. Wash me from your precious blood and take me, hallelujah, to be in the family of God. As you said that prayer, beloved, you are now born again. Your situation will turn around. The Bible says you are a new creature. You are a new species. You are like a newborn baby that you have never been existed before, because you have been washed by the blood of Jesus. Totally washed. Hallelujah. Being washed by the blood. So you are not a child of God. Beloved, look for a Bible and begin to read. Look for people that are really seeking the kingdom of God. Not the gossiper. Those that are seeking the kingdom of God. Gather yourself and begin to pray with them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. And bye-bye. God bless you. It's the end. And we love you all. And thank you for watching. Hallelujah. May the Lord be with you and your family as you go to school. In Jesus' name, expect to see you from Tuesday to Friday. In the mighty name of God. Bye-bye. Love you. Bye.